Look at how quickly Sven is taking this one down.
Vulcan's there! Though. Oh, he mistimes the headbutt, but the Bumatone coming out still! Perks though! Vulcan still does a lot of damage. The quickness coming out to the back as Inspire's killed off Sven, but Perks is still alive! Perks survives, Chimpy dies, and Perks starts to rampage through Rogue! It's C9 on their way to the quarterfinals! In the group of death, C9 breathe life into North America!
What's up, everyone? I'm Captain Flowers, and I want to welcome you back to the Out Play-by-Play Worlds Edition, where we're going to be taking a look at the who, the why, the how, and the what the f*** of Worlds 2021. Throughout the group stage, we have seen some absolute bangers, but nothing was more nerve-wracking than the final moments of chaos in the tiebreaker match between Cloud9 and Rogue that left everyone on the edge of their seats. Let's take a deep dive into the action and see how Cloud9 managed to get through the group of death for some of that sweet, sweet in Ahopi. To kick things off, both teams played a close back and forth. With Trimby roaming up to the mid lane, Perks burned both his summoner spells for the Great Escape to no avail as his EU brethren drew first blood. But just shortly after, it was Cloud9's star mid laner who found himself laughing in more ways than one. First, finding a kill of his own off a beautiful setup from Blabber, but then also doing this.
Flash movement speed, Perks low as well. He dodges back!
Why?
And the action didn't stop there. Come the mid-game, it was neck and neck as both teams continued to trade blows and objectives, with C9 having the advantage in map control and towers destroyed, while Rogue bested them in kills and Drake secured from a near dead even gold differential. But what's important to note here is the drafts on both sides. Rogue opt for a composition with strong side lanes, lots of poke, and an emphasis on finding picks while using Realm Warp to maximize teamfight opportunities. Their issue? They're crippled by a single point of engage on just Rakan. On the flip side, Cloud9 opt for a comp with huge teamfight threat as the game goes on. Multiple options for engage, tons of damage, and mobility to weave in and out of skirmishes. Oh, and Perks also has an 80% all-time win rate on LeBlanc, which, let's just say, was on full display in a variety of ways. 26 minutes in, we get our first fight as both sides position around the Infernal Drake, but pay attention to the details. Trimby, who's their only option to find an engage, doesn't have flash, and Curtain Call is on cooldown. So, with the advantage in map control, vision, and ultimates available, Cloud9 easily secure the Drake. It's at this point that Rogue look to initiate a fight, but pay attention to Fudge, whose flank pressure forces Rogue to not overstep on the right side, and Sven, who uses bullet time to zone both Larsen and Hansama away on the left. Because of this, Rogue become disjointed and lack the maximum output of their carries, and C9 come out on top in a 2-for-1, with the rest running for the hills. As the game went on and the tides tilted back and forth to either side, so did Perks, who walked right into no man's land and got caught with Trimby lurking in the shadows. As costly as the mistake was, Cloud9 made the best of it, securing their second Infernal Drake of the game, but losing Fudge and both the remaining top turrets to Oduwamne, who was split pushing the entire time as a result. And the madness didn't stop there. Just shortly after, with the next crucial objective of Baron in play, both teams look to set up. With both Perks and Fudge still respawning, it's Rogue who are in prime position and begin chunking away at the Baron. But as Cloud9 make their way over, it's Rogue who chooses to disengage, leaving C9 all the real estate to move in and start the Baron themselves. It's at this point for Rogue that things really take a turn for the worse. Take a look at Perks, who's made his way into the brush, chunk Inspired down to just half his health. Because of this, Inspired is forced into the Raptor Pit to smite his health back. Now, with no other way of getting into the Baron Pit other than walking up, Rogue are forced to make their move. But take a look at their vision. They cannot see a single thing and have no information on the Baron's health bar thanks to a control ward. But watch Inspired, who instead of walking up to contest, dances around the river before it's too late as Cloud9 safely secures the objective. From there, it's all downhill for the European squad as Cloud9 flip the switch to first eviscerate Trimby, then turn their focus onto Hans Sama, who gets punted into the fray as the dominoes begin to fall with C9 completing the ace. But they couldn't end. Without any minion waves pushing in, Cloud9 were forced to reset before taking the mid inhibitor turret as well as Soul Point for a 4,500 gold lead. Rogue would eventually find a favorable teamfight of their own after some mistimed Qs from Cloud9 and secure Baron as well as Soul Point as a result, bringing the game back to even. 44 minutes into the game, as both teams play a game of chicken back and forth in the mid lane, it's Cloud9 who pull the trigger first as Blabber goes in for the engage and Fudge TPs in. Fudge immediately gets melted, but isn't out of the fight just yet, with Guardian Angel being his saving grace. And as Hans Sama opens up the curtain call, it looks terrible for the North American side. But pay attention to the decision making from Perks, who single-handedly saves Cloud9 this fight. Watch as he geniusly weasels his way into the backline, first distorting over the wall and popping Sweeper to scan for any wards. Then, once he gets close, he uses R to distort again onto Hans Sama with a combo of Q and E for the kill, but just narrowly misses out as the Rogue AD carry survives in the smallest of margins thanks to his heal and Bloodthirster shield. And Perks wasn't done there. With the Infernal Soul just around the corner, both teams look to set up. But take a look at the positioning of Rogue. Cloud9 can see four members of the EU squad thanks to a control ward in the mid lane brush, and know that Oduwamne is completely separated from his team and vulnerable in the jungle after revealing himself just earlier. Now keep your eyes on Perks, who goes on the hunt as he walks into the fog of war, going unseen by any members of Rogue. As Oduwamne walks down, Perks immediately pounces onto the lonesome top laner, who pops stopwatch. But with his team in no position to help, and Perks' insane damage this late into the game, Oduwamne was, well, Odagane. Watch as Perks uses a combo of E, Q, and R to delete his EU brethren and flash to safety with Larson's Realm Warp coming in. Just like that, Perks, the man who was brought into Cloud9 as the answer for North America's international struggles, rises to the occasion and puts the team on his back. Off that single play, Cloud9 would go on to secure both the Infernal Soul and Baron before sieging the European base. But pay attention to Perks once again, who's really just playing with his food at this point, two-shot Oduwamne with just Q and R to burn his Guardian Angel. And so, with Rogue's base in shambles after losing all the remaining tier 3s and two inhibitors, C9 reset. 53 minutes into the game, with Elder Dragon in play and super minions marching up mid and bot, the North American squad looked poised to win. Having GA on both Fudge and Blabber and none on Rogue, the next team fight skews in their favor. As Cloud9 make their way towards the Elder Drake, it's Vulcan who spots the 5-man Realm Warp and goes in for the flash engage. Fortunately for Rogue, he mistimes his Q. But unfortunately for Rogue, with the rest of Cloud9 waiting in the weeds and on full builds plus an Infernal Soul, it's all but downhill from there. Watch as Sven unleashes the bullet time onto the grouped up members of Rogue to chunk them down. Vulcan actually headbutts Inspired right onto Sven, which does him no favors as the Cloud9 AD carry meets his death. But at the same time, with Perks still alive and dealing free uncontested damage from the brush, Rogue get eaten up. Watch as he first chunks Oduwamne down to just a quarter of his health after closing the distance with distortion, then hitting him with the R before distorting away and going back in to finish off Trimby with a QE combo. From there, he turns his sights onto Inspired with an auto Q before flash distorting back in to send Inspired back to Valhalla. From there, it's all but over for the side of Rogue as Fudge makes quick work of Larson on the back line, while Perks chases down Oduwamne for the triple kill. And after Fudge comes out of GA, he struts right in to finish off Hans Sama for the ace. And so, just like that, Cloud9 made history as the first NA team to ever win a World's Group Stage tiebreaker, albeit in the Battle of the West. They completed the miracle run after a 0-3 start in the Group of Death and became the only North American representative to prevail into the quarterfinal stage. I'm Captain Flowers, and that does it for this week's episode of the Out Play-by-Play Worlds Edition. Let me know what you think. Has this been the best Worlds group stage to date? Or have we seen better? Be sure to follow @LOLESports on Twitter to keep up to date with everything League of Legends Esports, and we'll catch you back here next time.